Good morning, students. I hope you must be safe and sound within your home. And in this period of lockdown, you must be taking all the precautionary methods that have been told by our government. Students, we know that in this lockdown period, the academic session of our school and other educational institution has been affected, and your studies are also getting hampered. So that is why we have taken the initiative, our school has taken the initiative to upload the videos of several chapters of different subjects, so that you can take the benefits from those videos and you can continue your learning. So student, in this first video, I am going to discuss the first chapter of history for class 10th, that is Rise of Nationalism in Europe. So before starting this chapter, we should discuss some of the important key terms that you might face within this chapter. The first key term that comes before us is the word nationalism itself. What actually the word nationalism means? So the word nationalism means love for our own country. If we talk about the European society during the 19th century, the nationalism or nationalistic feeling was completely absent there. And the main reason for the absence of nationalism in the European people was the existence of multinational dynastic empire within the Europe. What actually these multinational dynastic empires are? So these multinational dynastic empires are the large kingdoms, in which the people belonging to different ethnic groups used to survive. These different ethnic groups were having different culture, tradition, and traits, and thus there was no commonness within those ethnic groups, due to which there was an absence of nationalism within the European society. Now we will go through the main chapter. And student, as you will start the first chapter, you can see that the chapter is starting with a painting. And this painting is from the series of four paintings that has been made by one of the famous French artist, Frederic Soriot, in the year 1848. This painting is actually an utopian vision of Frederic Soriot, that how he wanted the European societies to be. Within this painting, we can see that the various people are joining the procession, and they are holding the flags which are representing different countries, and they are passing through the Statue of Liberty and are paying their homage to it. In this painting, we can see the various countries such as USA, Switzerland, France, Germany, Italy, Lombardy, Kingdom of Two Slices, Austria, Hungary. These are the various kingdoms. These were the various kingdoms which are joining this procession. Along with it, we can see within this painting that the Christ, saint, and the angels are gazing from the skies, which is a symbol of fraternity. So this painting is completely an imaginary vision of Frederic Soriot, and through this imaginary painting, or through this utopian vision, he wanted the people of European countries to enthuse, to get freedom from the monarchical rule. Through this painting, he has tried to end the monarchical rule that has been existing in the in the European societies from a long period of time, and he wanted to set up a democratic and republic government within the European countries. This nationalism has been one of the key tools in the 19th century, which have led to many of the important social and political changes within the European countries. One of the concept, one of the new concept that has been developed by nationalism in the European country was the concept of nation state. What actually this nation state means? So, nation state means such a kind of a state or such a kind of country in which majority of the people along with its government is sharing a common identity or a commonness with each other and is sharing a common history and descent. So, such a kind of country or such a kind of a state is known as the nation state. The rise of nationalism in the European countries or the spread of nationalism in the European country has been the result of various struggle movements that has been laid down by various intellectuals, leaders, and in it the poets, writers, and many intellectuals have played a very crucial role. So now we will come to see some of such events and struggles which have played a crucial role in spreading nationalism within the European countries. So now, students, we will go through the first part of this chapter, that is French Revolution and the idea of nation. French Revolution is remarked as one of the important revolution or the change that have took place in the world history. Because under this French Revolution, many new ideas have emerged, such as the idea of liberty, equality, fraternity. It all had emerged from this French Revolution and have spread to the whole European countries. Or ultimately, we can say that these ideas, the new ideas that had emerged from the French Revolution, it had spread to the different parts of the world and had helped them in organizing revolutionary movement within their own countries also. Within this French Revolution that had occurred in the year 1789, we know that the monarchical rule of Louis XVI has came to an end, and it had led to the establishment of a democratic government in the French society. Now, the French society, the government of the French society has came under the French citizen, and in order to develop a sense of collective identity among each other, the French revolutionaries have brought many changes during this revolutionary period. So some of these changes we will discuss out here. So the first measure that has been taken by the French revolutionary, it was the development of idea of la patrie and licitium. La patrie means the fatherland and licitium means the citizen. Along with it, the equal rights were being provided to all the citizen. Along with it, the all the internal custom duties have been abolished. Then new hymns and oaths were being taken in the name of nations. Then the general assembly was being national assembly, and along with that, a centralized administrative system has been laid down within the French society. And also the French language has been declared as the official language in France. So this were all the revolutionary changes that we can see within France to develop a collective identity among its citizen. So now the French revolutionaries thought that it is their duty to spread this revolution to the other parts of the European countries also, so that there can be an end to the absolute institutions, or there can be an end of the monarchical rule within the European society. So many of the French revolutionaries have went to the different countries to organize revolutionary wars in this in those countries. Along with it, in many of the countries, the students and the worker unions have started to form Jacobins club. You must be knowing about this Jacobin club. It was one of the famous political institution in France, which had helped in organizing the French Revolution. Then under this French Revolution, as this French Revolution was going on, due to political instability in France, Napoleon Bonaparte has came into power, and the rise of Napoleon Bonaparte in France has led to the decline of democratic rule, and once again a dictatorial rule has been laid down in France. But even though the rule of Napoleon Bonaparte, under the rule of Napoleon Bonaparte, even though the democratic rule has been settled, then also we can see that many kind of revolutionary administrative changes have been introduced by Napoleon Bonaparte, which is popularly known as Napoleonic Code or Civil Code of 1804. Under this Napoleonic Code of 1804 or Civil Code of 1804, many kind of administrative changes have been introduced within the French society. The first change we can experience here, it was the end of the privileges that were being enjoyed by the birth, by especially by the nobilities and the clerical classes. Then the right to have private property. Then the old guilds that were existing, it were being removed. Then transport and communication facilities have been developed. Peasants have been made free from the serfdom, and the manorial dues have been ended. And along with it, the traders and the businessmen have been made free, as they were now free for forming their trade guilds. And introduction of uniform weighting and measure system has been introduced, and a common currency has been also introduced under this revolutionary administrative changes. So in many of the places such as Holland and Switzerland, this administrative changes have been welcomed by the people, and the French armies were being looked as a harbinger of the liberty, or the carrier of the liberty. But soon they come to realize that this administrative changes, or that this administrative freedom that they have been getting, it was on the verge of the it was on the course of their political freedom. Because this administrative changes on one side was providing economic freedom to the French people, but on the other side it was neglecting or it was denying the political freedom to the French people. On one side, this administrative changes have been introduced, and many kind of new economic freedom has been provided to the people, but on the other side there has been an increased taxation. Then censorship policy has been laid down. Then along with that, the people were being forcibly recruited within the French armies. So that is why we can see that there has been a mixed reaction of the people over this administrative changes in many of the French acquired nations. So students, this is the end of the part 1, and this part is coming to the end here, and in the next part we will discuss the further chapters, and there is a task for you also, that after going through this video within your notebook, you should mention some of the question. The first question is, what is a nation state? You have to find the answer of this question. What is nation state? Second question is, what are the features of Nepali code or civil code of 1804? So these are the two questions for which you have to find the answer, and in the next class we will deal with the further portion of this first chapter. Thank you.